Joe DeBlasi for the Varsity Sports Network at Mount St. Joe. Coach Pat Clatchey, 502 wins in his illustrious 22-year career, 16 overall titles in the regular season and BCL and MIAA tournaments. And today was a pretty big day for him again. Three of his players going on to Division I schools, Phil Booth to Villanova, Jalen Adams to Jacksonville, Jordan McNeil to Towson. And one of the things I'm going to try to get Pat to talk about, besides the outlook with these guys back and other returnees, Henry Sims, a graduate who we covered years ago, is now with the Cleveland Cavaliers. And Pat, you can talk about him and where Will Thomas is. And senior year for Eric Atkins, who I think is going to have more wins under his belt than probably any player that ever played at Notre Dame. So you take it away. There's a big lead in for you. Take it wherever you want to go.
A lot of area to cover, and certainly some good areas to cover. I'll start with Henry. He's the first guy from our program or from Mount St. Joe ever to play in the NBA. So that's always very rewarding. I'm really excited for him. You know, his hard work has come to fruition. I keep in touch with him and his mom quite often. They're both very excited, and he's just really relishing the opportunity to continue his career at the NBA level.
Well, go on and talk about the guys that were here today that are going to D1 schools. And one of the other lead-ins I left out was we're in a brand new facility, the Smith Building, and it's like being on a college campus. So you can talk a little bit about what's been like already to be practicing in a brand new gymnasium.
Yeah, well, the three guys that signed today, Phil Booth to Villanova, Jalen Adams to Jacksonville, and Jordan McNeil to Towson, just really excited and proud of them and happy for them and their families to continue their education and their basketball career at the next level and at the Division I level. It's a great opportunity, and it's just another list of guys for us to, be proud of and follow them throughout their career. They've been a crucial part of our success the past couple of years. So proud of those guys to continue that long list of, Division I players from our program.
A couple words about Eric up at Notre Dame, going to be a senior already.
Yeah, it's hard to believe how, quick 4 years can go. I mean, Eric, has had a great career at Notre Dame. He's on the Cousy list of, top point guards in the country, on track to get his degree. Has a chance to be the all-time winningest point guard in Notre Dame history. And I think his next game he will eclipse, 1,000 points. So, it's great following those guys. Will Thomas is playing professionally in Italy. Dino Gregory's playing, professionally in Germany. Louis Birdsong's playing pro in Germany. So it's just, it's a very proud moment. And you mentioned, the new Smith Center. Which we are extremely excited about. Our old gym was a lot of thrills, but not too many frills. And this is just a state-of-the-art, top-notch facility that is just spectacular, in my opinion. And I think it's hard-pressed to be the top facility in the area.
Well, you got a lot to be proud of because all the guys you mentioned and others who have gone on to be great successes in life have come through your program and under your tutelage here. Wanted to ask you, you won the BCL tournament last year. It was tooth and nail with you and John Carroll. They end up getting the MIAA. And of course, with these guys, these three particular people, players we've talked about already, Phil, Jalen, and Jordan, you got a lot of talent surrounding them as well. And a lot of people are predicting to me that, well, St. Joe may be the team to beat again. I know you won't go as far as to say that, but how do you feel about the overall composition of this year's team?
We have a chance to be a pretty good team. We've always tried to be really solid in the backcourt. And, with those three guys, Phil, Jordan, Jalen, and a sophomore, Randy Miller, who's a very talented player. Kyle Dorn is a three-year varsity player. Graham Searing, Xander Ware provide size off the bench. And then, Doc Barnes certainly proved once he moved up to the varsity level last year that he's a very talented and capable player. For a sophomore, Doc is a very good player and somebody that, we're expecting big things from.
Yeah, he stepped up in a couple of key situations last year, I remember.
Yes.
Well, Pat, we'll be here next week when you officially christen the new gymnasium in the Smith Center when you take on Annapolis Area Christian. I appreciate your time today. I know you have a heavy schedule and practice coming up. I appreciate you coming on, and we'll see you real soon.
All right, thank you very much.